Welcome to the YGTV News with Bouchra El Mansouri.
Welcome to the YGTV News. These are the main headlines today on Thursday, the 7th of June. I'm Bouchra El Mansouri. Democratic Reform Commission urged to keep current voting system. Royal Visit Itinerary released. Miami Cruise Company schedules further calls to Gib. Nature Group hit financially after port explosion. Government publishes command paper on public interest disclosure. And finally, Spring Festival short story winners. Last week, the Commission of Democratic and Political Reform published their consultation paper, as requested by the government in March. The document contains various proposals on parliamentary reform, such as no fixed terms for future chief ministers and the possibility of creating an independent authority to oversee the distribution of government funds to the media. Within the category of parliamentary reform, the Commission mentions the possibility of splitting Gibraltar into constituencies to follow the parliamentary system seen in the House of Commons in the UK. The majority view of the Commission is not to partition Gibraltar into constituencies. If any members of the public wish to respond to the consultation paper, they can email comdpr@gibtelecom.com. The closing date for responses is the 28th of September 2012. The Commission will publish a report to Parliament in June 2013. Their Royal Highnesses, the Earl and Countess of Wessex, are visiting the Rock from Monday to Wednesday of next week as part of Her Majesty the Queen's Diamond Jubilee celebrations. During their stay, they will visit many parts of Gibraltar and meet a cross-section of people from across the local community. Arriving at lunchtime on Monday, their Royal Highnesses are being met by His Excellency the Governor and the Chief Minister and will be welcomed with a guard of honour. At a public ceremony at 7 p.m. on Monday, the royal visitors are laying the foundation stone for Gibraltar's Diamond Jubilee Monument on Limewall Road, where it overlooks the site of the new Jubilee Commonwealth Park. They will then move on to reception and dinner, both hosted by the government, at which they will be guests of honour. On Tuesday evening, their Royal Highnesses attend the Queen's Birthday Parade in Casemates Square, followed by the Queen's Birthday Party at the convent. On Wednesday, the couple will depart from the new airport terminal and board their flight back to London. Following a substantial dip in cruise liners stopping off in Gibraltar, Minister for Tourism Neil Costa has secured two additional calls from Miami-based Azamara Club Cruises for this year. The 700-passenger ship is scheduled to call once, while her sister ship, Azamara Quest, will stop at the Rock four times later this year. In 2013, the Azamara Quest will return to Gibraltar six times. A government statement noted that this increase in activity from the company is a result of discussions between Minister Costa and Claudius Dossel, the company's Director of Deployment and Destinations, as well as other major cruise lines senior executives based in Miami. Reports from StockMarketWire.com have suggested that port facilities company Nature Group saw a massive loss last year after the yet unresolved insurance claim regarding the explosion in Gibraltar's port last May. The article states that Nature's revenues for 2011 were £15.5 million compared to £6.83 million in 2010. Regardless of the £2.9 million increase in operating profit, pre-tax profit took a substantial hit of the significant costs that were incurred after the explosion. A great expenditure was necessary for repairs and clean-up work to the tank along the North Mole. A further £200,000 was also used for legal advice after the accident. The government yesterday released a draft bill for the Employment Act 2012 as a command paper. A government statement claims that this is in keeping with the GSLP Liberals' manifesto commitment to provide protection for employees and other workers who disclose information in the public interest. The public have been invited to provide observations and comment. All comments on command papers should be sent by email to command.papers@gibraltar.gov.gi. And finally, the winners of the Spring Festival Short Story Competition were announced yesterday by Minister for Culture, Mr. Stephen Linares. Overall winner for the Adults Prize was awarded to Elena Sicatiel. Second place in the Adults category was awarded to Gail Francis Diron. In the school year 4-5 category, Jodie King won first place and second place was awarded to Paul Francis. In the year 6-7, first place was won by David Nicholas Garcia. Second place was awarded to Isabel Louise Davies. Year 12-13, first place winner was Raquel Lee Levy, and second place was awarded to Aidan Charles Serra. That's the YGTV news. I'm back tomorrow evening. See you then.